Welcome to episode 6 of the Spare Change Challenge. I'm back to playing cash games tonight. And I'm streaming it on Twitch. I'm going to bet the bottom left. Top pair, good kicker. It is a limped pot, so have to proceed cautiously. If you missed the last episode earlier today, I played a couple hyper turbo six-man sit and goes. Won one of the two. Got coolered in first one I played, but the second one I took down. I also played a couple heads-up sit and goes. Played two of those and won one of two of those. Ran really bad, but still managed to win one of two. So I think bread and butter force is going to be cash games. The sit and goes are nice for taking shots at building the bankroll potentially more rapidly. We'll continue to do that. Good lead here with the double gutter. It's not best double gutter. It is a limped pot. A lot of hands that would call the turn are also going to call the river if we don't get there. And when we do get there, it's kind of obvious. I just think it's a good spot just to check fold. Almost better to lead a gut shot there. Not for equity purposes, but for implied odds, I guess. Certainly heads up, it would be a lead and a barrel off. Flop top pair, insta-check back for deception. And pot control. 8-9 gets there. If somebody leads, I probably will raise for value. And protection as well. And now I'm just going to bet straight value. Bet a little big. Not too big, but big enough. I expect to get called by any 10. Maybe even a hand like Queen 9 or spade draws, of course. Those hands are likely to lead, but it's still possible. So we'll play cash maybe for 20-30 minutes, and then maybe do either a couple of heads-up turbos or 6-max hypers. Or if we're running really good in cash, might just keep doing that. This table doesn't look very good. I know it's a small sample, but I got 20-20, 20-20, 40-40, 33-0 to my left here. Probably just get off this table after this hand. My flop open-ended, so just a bet and get it in if necessary. I'm going to lead top here on top left. Any hand that calls the flop probably is also going to call the turn. Don't want to get blown off my equity. Potentially, he has some draws in his range. So if I check back here, I think I can raise a lot of his weak river leads and get him off, say, a 9 or maybe even some 10s sometimes. Not a whole lot of 3s in my range. That's actually a pretty bad card for me to raise. A 4 or a 3 were pretty bad cards. I think, obviously, a queen or jack were good, but like ace, a king, an 8, a 7, 6, a 5, those were good cards for me to bluff raise the river. Hard for me to rep a 3 right now. I think a 9 just snaps me off. So the only thing I'm really getting him off of is like 8, 7, which I'm beating anyway. I mean, if he's got a hand like that, I probably just want to call here. But I think he'll also have hands like, I don't know, like ace highs and things like that sometimes. And obviously, it's going to give it to him. He's been pretty tight and passive so far. And he does show a 10, so. Obviously part of his range. But I am going to leave this table. I think there's better spots. I have 2 overs and a gut shot on an extremely draw-heavy board. I think just checking back is probably a good play here. It's a pretty good turn, because I would check back a lot of 10s here. I don't expect to get him off a queen, but I could get him off like a 9 or a pocket pair. Something like that. So I'm going to go ahead and raise with a lot of equity. He does happen to peel with a hand like 10x, a 9x, and I think this is just a bet fold on the river for value. I'm trying to get value off a queen or a 9, and not a 10, obviously. I may have said 10 erroneously a minute ago, but obviously a 10's not going anywhere, but yeah. No matter what came on the river, I was betting again. Yeah, I may have misspoke. But yeah, I can definitely get better to fold by raising that turn. And if it doesn't fold, a lot of hands that are ahead will go ahead and fold the river. And I had a ton of cards to improve my hand as well. And set up a bigger value bet on the river, which actually is what happened. So you can't just call that turn. I think it's very weak, especially when he leads weakly like that. I think it was a min bet. I'm just going to leave with my gutter here, I think. His limping range does connect a lot with this board, but I think it's still a profitable bet with the four potential outs. I'm going to get off this table because all I think all I've got left is passive players. Try to find a better game. This one probably is okay. This one's a good game, it looks like. Sure about this one. Probably okay because this guy's got 99 cents. This guy's 67, 67, but that's over three hands. So. Sample size. This isn't the typical ace-high board. I think a lot of times he's going to have a draw and he's just not going to go anywhere. So we have really no equity in the pot. So I think we either got a raise or fold. And with no equity, I think it's probably okay just to fold this. Am I under the gun here? Yeah, I think. Right? Yeah. Dead small. So we flop top pair on a draw heavy board. I think it's just value and get it in. I don't think there's any checking back on this board. I mean, he is an aggressive player, but he's so aggressive looking that I think checking back to a deuce is probably not the best play, especially on this board. Like on a 10, 5, 4 maybe sometimes. I think just betting big and getting it in is probably best. Let him be aggressive. There's a ton of hands that I beat that could they could bluff raise this flop. It's one of the worst cards, but I'm still going to bet fold. Get donk bet into in a three-way pot. I'm just going to fold this one. I'm going to bet for value on the turn here. It's a bet fold. If he leads, I'm just going to fold. I'm just taking my hand to showdown now. I'm open-ended here on the turn. I'm going to call a min bet, even though my outs are kind of dirty. I'm not going to fold to a min bet. I think I can actually rep the diamond now, though. I think he's just going to have an 8 or a 6 a lot here. And a limped pot, he might just fold. This guy's really aggressive. I'm just going to jam. Simplify things up here. Going to pot it. Rep the diamonds. Hope I can get him off a 6. Oops, I guess I need to find a table up here. Bet a little big here. Don't want to get bluff raised on this board. Not that this is the type of player necessarily to do that. I got to protect my hand. Make it look like a value bet. Could potentially get him off a hand as strong as sevens. At least by the turn. Table. Definitely a lot of games right now. I guess Friday night and stuff. Ideally, I would like to play for like 7 hours tonight, but not gonna happen. This guy just min-raised, min-3-bet. Obviously, ace-4-diamonds plays really well in position. I think I can min-raise this. Freeze a lot of hands like, and get value from hands like queens or king-queen. And mitigate being against a better ace. I highly doubt he min-bets an ace, unless he's exactly got aces or kings here. Which is possible. Some people might play it that way. Yeah, so I'm going to fold here. It's probably a slow play of some kind. He probably min-bet thinking he was inducing, but I mean, I was going to raise if he bet 15 cents, so he actually saved me money by doing that. I'm never continuing in this spot. It's just, this is just really strong. I would be amazed if he's bluffing there. Against this player, I'm just going to jam blind versus blind spot. I'm just going to min bet lead on the bottom left here. I think it accomplishes the same thing as a 10 cent bet. I'm going to bet 2 big blinds and then 3 big blinds on the river. Assuming like a heart doesn't peel or something. Yeah, I'm definitely betting again. I think a lot of their range is just hard draws and such. Maybe small pairs. They'll raise if I'm beat and fold if... or call if I'm winning. Guessing he probably has like 4x here. I'm guessing he probably wouldn't do that with a heart flush, because obviously the board just paired twice. So I'm not even beating some of his, well, pretty sure he just calls with like 10x, so. This is either a slow play or he just has a 4. Could be 4 deuce even. But once again, I get value when I'm ahead, and I lose the least when I'm behind that spot. I'm not confident the games are even that good tonight. So yeah, I'm just going to bet for value. Turn here. Probably can go for a little thin value here from a queen. I'm bet a little less than half pot. Yeah, I'm not confident this is a great table here. Well, actually, this guy just limped, so stay there. This one I'm not sure. This guy's 50-0, but that's only, well, it is over 16 hands, so I'll probably stay here. This guy's 67-8, so I'll stay here. This one doesn't look that great so far, so I'll probably get off of this one. Then go ahead and do that. The cursed slot. Is that the second or third time I've left that slot because the game wasn't that great? This guy shoves a limped pot. I'm assuming he'll have a lot of hands like 8, 9, 10x, maybe 7x. I mean, a lot of random hands. It's a matter of whether I want to raise or just call. It's hard for him to have something, so I think just calling is best. Oh, we have the same hand. Cool. Cool in the fact that he didn't have a better two pair. He's going to have two pair, let him be the same two pair. Kind of strange though, we both had 7-3 in the blinds and both flop pair. Pretty unusual. I would defend something like Queen 10 suited here. There's a lot of domination potential against me here. I think I'll be a nit and fold this one. Jack 10 probably would definitely call. Queen 10, the second worst position, is a little iffy. This player is just not wide enough of an opener, I don't think, at least not in the small sample I have. Yeah, I think this table now is crap. Well, I don't know, that was pretty fishy. But he doesn't have any money really, so probably just plan on sitting out when the blind comes around, but I'll reevaluate here by the time that comes around. I think the only thing I'm really getting somebody off of is like ace high here. Pretty much the rest of his range is continuing a lot on this board. I think I can just check back, reevaluate, depending on the turn. Obviously I'm just going to bet now for value. Yeah, I think this is, the only fish I have is two to my left. I think I'm going to go and get off of this one as well. Bet on this table a while. Brush it up. We're at 5 and L. If that was a 200 and L game, I would stay all day. But 5 and L, I think we can do better than that, right? Should be able to. Bunch of full stacks. We'll try it out though. I guess the days of every single macro stakes table having 3 to 4 fish is long gone. Not saying these regs are good, but I'm just saying they're there, and they're not going to be as big of a donator as typical 67-0 or 43-3 would be. Yeah, I'm definitely leaving this crap table too. This looks like a 400 NL table with these stats. This guy open shove. That's a good sign. Potential tilter. Or that's just how he plays ace-king or something. Whoops. Where'd my table go that I just opened? Let's see if he shoves again this hand. Whoops. That sucks. Might have been the table I was just on. Table gonna break now? Oh, I can't seem to find a table. Gonna bet the high, low board. Probably just get off of this table as well. I will post my small blind though. I'll just go ahead and leave now. I'm not gonna play heads up. Yeah, a few of these tables are breaking, so. Yeah, I mean, I was going to think about limping here, but now I'm just going to jam. 88 cents, expecting to get called really by a ton of this guy's under the gun range. Like probably 80% of his range. Well, he's 36-27, but that doesn't mean he's not a little tight there. Yeah, I just don't. I mean, I guess I'll stay because these guys open wide. Because rebetting. I can 3-bet a little wider there, so I guess it's okay. But, you know, these games are not looking that great. I think I might just play a couple of sit-and-goes and end this session at that point. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and do that. We'll get off these tables. See if we can find a sit-and-go real quick to play. Hey, so we crossed $30, so we were slightly up that session. Not much really happened, right? So it's good to be up when you're... I don't know that I was necessarily card dead, but didn't really... I don't think I had any all-ins, right? So let's check out sit and goes here. We got... I play a heads-up. Yeah, let's play a heads-up. Those are fun. Just gonna bet for value. Assuming he's not gonna limp many aces, but he could have like a 9 or a hard draw or gut shots. It could even be a check call situation on a lot of rivers there. Just gonna do the typical strategy, and that's raise wide. I'm gonna get a little tricky up front here on the first couple hands. Play a little unorthodox to maybe get him off. Guard. Yeah, so I'm gonna probably have to fold. Yeah. You definitely have like ace here. Like ace 7? You have a 9? Unlikely he has a 9. I mean, you bet kind of quick. I wonder if this could be like Jack 10. I'm wondering on a King Queen Jack, would he just call me with Ace High? I guess he could call with Ace Jack. But wouldn't he be 3-betting that a lot? I mean, I just, not much makes sense here for an ace. Why would he just call my turn bet with just ace high? Unless he has exactly ace seven here or ace jack. I might be good here. I don't know. Yeah, so we catch his bluff there. I mean, it just, ace just didn't make sense there. The aces that he could have, the only exact hand I could put him on was ace. And I mean, I really thought he could have been value betting with jack 10 and not realizing, because he bet so quick. So, whenever I get control in a sit no heads up, I play for small pots. I small ball it. I tend to. I'm going to raise this turn. I'm actually going to bet half pot and expect him to bluff again on a lot of rivers. That's a strange raise. I guess he could have a six here. It's possible he could slow play it till now. I mean, for one thing, I'm in control of this. I don't really need to win this spot. It's like, if I call this, he's probably going to follow through if he's bluffing. I'm just going to give it to him here. I'm going to keep this in mind, though, and play it a little different next time. I will just check back my five and pot control against this bluffy type player. Play a little more passive and let him bluff. I think it's probably a decent strategy. I'm not going to rep anything here. I'm just going to let him win it. Thinking of tightening up a little bit on the button, but he is, I think, not the best player, so I do want to play pots against him. I'm going to bet for value on the turn as well. He doesn't necessarily have to have me beat. There's a few draws out there. Don't think that card is going to allow him to... I don't think he's ever folding a jack, even if the ace didn't come. So I expect him to have quite a few jacks, but I also expect him to have some eights. And like some busted gutter balls. And sometimes a 7x hand. And then, again, he could just have crap, you know? It's kind of strange. Not sure what he was hoping there. So this is a complete whale fish here. So I'm just going to play accordingly. Just play for value. You know, avoid complex decisions and bluffs. I'm just going to let him dump his chips off. I'm not going to bluff a calling station either. Looks like he's going to play 100% of hands. So I'm going to try and chip away and try to get up above 2,000 here before the blinds get up too high. And then just outplay him in, you know, bigger blind situations. Try and just trap and such. I'm going to bet for value, though, with a 6, because he's already showed that he can call with air. I'm gonna tighten up slightly on the button. Going to probably keep it to about 75% range. And I'm going to do very little defending, because the times he raises, he probably just has it. He's limping. He's like seeing me, letting me see all these flops, so. I'm just going to try and maintain my chip stack, let the blinds go up, and just play the percentages and win the tournament that way over time. I see this a lot. People just go into shove fold mode very, very early. In these. It's probably just a lack of post-flop skill that makes people do that. They don't know what to do with like an ace-10 type hand, so they're either going to shove it or they're just not going to call. Probably call all their marginal stuff and maybe medium strength stuff and like medium strong hands and strong hands. Except for maybe like the nuts, they'll just shove. I'll see if he's going to get into where he's going to be doing that a lot. Don't want to get blown off my equity here. I think he's continuing a lot. His range, I mean, I know he's got a super wide range, but a lot of any range is going to connect with this board. So I'm just going to take it to the turn. I think I'll have the best hand a lot anyway. I'm not. I normally would raise a player here, but this guy's shown that he's bluffy, so I'm just going to let him bluff two streets. I'm not really worried about a jack. Yeah, so. I was like confident. I was like a good 100% there. But, you know, there are some potential jacks. Thinking about betting a third of my stack here. And shoving. Mini flop. Give him a chance to put tournament on the line. If I thought that he was trapping there, I would obviously just shove. See if he's... I don't think he's 3-betty enough necessarily, so I'm just going to limp and trap with the nines. I'm just going to check back. I'm going to give him a chance to bluff. Bet half pot. I think he's going to have a lot of busted draws here. I'm going to actually bet min just to give him a chance to bluff raise. I think if I min bet, he'll bluff raise a lot. He did have a hand that he's either bluffing or folding. I like that I gave him that opportunity. Definitely going to defend. He's not stealing enough really for me to just get it in here though. I'm going to call. I'm going to check shove. I just think there's a lot of hands that are draws that he'll get it in with. He might get it in with like nines here, eights. Maybe even a hand as weak as like A7, 7-8 for sure. And I have a lot of equity, even if he happens to have a jack or something. So he pots it. He looks committed. There are actually some worse. I don't think he's going to do this with a straight or even a jack necessarily. I'm just going to get it in. I think he's bad enough that he can get it in with worse here. Unfortunately, he does have a jack. Sucks. But we hit two pair and we take down the tournament, which is fine. Hopefully he accepts a rematch. Oh, he declined. Well, darn. I'd like to play him again. So we hit $31. That's cool. Let's see if we have time. Yeah, we have time for one more of these. Let's try again. Win or lose, we're up tonight. Let's go for an extra dollar win here. Here we go.